If you are staring at a blank page, feeling overwhelmed by the thought of crafting a research proposal that will impress your committee, or you may have already begun but continue to second guess every section, unsure if you are meeting the unspoken expectations of academia, well, this video is for you. You are not alone. This frustration is precisely why I created this guide. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today, we are addressing problems that even experienced scholars find daunting. The research proposal. If you are new to this channel, my name is Dong Ling. After serving as a course coordinator for a graduating project at a prestigious business school and currently working as a founder and academic consultant, well, part of my job involves approving research proposals. I've identified exactly what works and what doesn't. Whether you are an undergrad facing your first big project, a master's student trying to get your thesis approved, or a doctoral candidate whose entire future depends on this document, I've got you covered. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear note map to create a proposal that not only gets approved, but also excites your committee. Before we dive in, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss our upcoming videos on conducting your research and writing your final paper. Now, let's transform your research anxiety into research confidence. Let's start with something none of those other videos mentioned. Understanding the psychology of the paper reading your proposal. Your reviews have the following characteristics. They are 1. Extremely busy. 2. Reading dozens of proposals. 3. Looking for reasons to say yes and reasons to say no. And then, let's have a look at what really makes reviewers sit up and take notice of your proposal. Here's the secret. A good proposal makes their job easier. It has crystal clear problem statements, clearly signaling, this research is valuable, feasible, and I'm the right person to do it. Every section of your proposal should reinforce these three points. It also shows realistic timelines that the people reviewing your proposal can believe. Most students make the mistake of focusing only on what interests them. However, successful proposals strike a balance between your passion and what matters to your field and your specific reviews. Let's look at how to strike that balance. Now, let's break down the perfect proposal structure. I'll show you exactly how to make each session compelling and engaging. Your proposal needs these components. Number 1. Title. A clear title that grabs attention and communicates your research clearly. Number 2. Abstract. A concise summary of your entire proposal, generally 200 words in length. Number 3. Introduction. Specific and answerable research questions, hypotheses if applicable, and the purpose of the study, with a hook and a structure of the remainder of the project that makes them clear and coherent. Number 4. Literature review. Aimed for 10 to 15 related core studies, showing gaps, not just summarizing, with a theoretical framework if applicable. Number 5. Methodology. Detailed enough to prove feasibility, showing how you will collect and analyze data. Number 6. Timeline. Realistic and well-balanced schedule for comparing your project. And then, number 7 is ethical considerations. respectful ethical principles, how you will ensure ethical conduct. Next, number 8, special resource requirements. For example, what resources and budget are required for this project? After that, number 9, expected outcomes and significance, why it matters. And finally, number 10, references, aimed for 15 to 20 references, demonstrating your knowledge base. To help you master each of these components, I'm creating a comprehensive video series dedicated to writing each part of your research proposal with expert precision. And the support of powerful AI tools. Please subscribe and turn on notifications so you don't miss any of these in-depth tutorials that will transform your proposal writing process. Now, let's focus on these three sessions where most proposals fail: the introduction, literature review, and methodology. I'll show you before and after examples of each to demonstrate the difference between rejection and approval. Alright, now that you can see the big picture, let's zoom in on that make or break first impression, your research problem. Your introduction needs to accomplish three things in the first paragraph. 1. Establish relevance. 2. Hint at the knowledge gap. And 3. Suggest why filling this gap matters. Now, if you look at the screen, you will see an example of a weak introduction followed by a strong introduction. See how the weak introduction states vaguely and then takes a long time to get to the point. In contrast, a strong introduction immediately indicates relevance to a current statistic or a convincing example, and then quickly establishes the specific problem at hand. Keep in mind that you only have roughly 30 seconds to persuade someone that your research is essential. Therefore, it's vital to use specific language, avoid jargon unless necessary, and connect your research to the real world whenever possible. With a compelling research problem established, it's time to demonstrate your scholarly expertise through a masterful literature review. A literature review isn't just about summarizing everything that's been written on your topic. Think of it more like, here's what people have been saying, and here's where I step in. When reading your sources, try organizing them by theme or idea rather than just by time. For each theme, ask yourself, what do you already know? What's still unclear or missing? Are there any arguments or disarguments? And more importantly, how does your research help move things forward? A big mistake people make, trying to include everything. Instead, focus on the key stuff, the most recent, relevant, and influential work. To make all of this way easier, I've put together a literature review notebook. It has templates to help you break down articles, see how ideas connect, and identify research gaps. There are even sections for comparing methods, understanding context, and evaluate critically. I'll walk you through exactly how to use it in another video, so your literature review won't just be good, it'll be next level. Feeling good about your literature review? Perfect! Let's shift gears and talk about how you are actually going to do this research. Alright, let's dive into the methodology session. This part is crucial because it's where the reviewers examine if your research is feasible. Here's the thing. Many proposals fail in this session. Why? Because they are either too vague or way too ambitious. You are suggesting something that sounds amazing, but it's just not realistic, given the time, budget, or resources you've. Remember, the reviewers are looking for feasibility. Can you actually do what you are proposing? Does it make sense? Okay, let's look at what a strong methodology session looks like. Specific sampling strategies with numbers, clear data collection procedures, analysis methods with justification, potential limitations and how you adjust them, ethical considerations, resource requirements and confirmation of access. The big deal, being specific to show you've thought through how your research will work in the real world. The key is to be exact. Don't just dream big. Make it practical. Once we have covered these three key sections where most proposals fail, let's move on to a critical question people often ask. What's the secret that separates a good proposal from a great one? Well, it's all about the language. Let me show you the specific phrases and transitions that signal confidence and clarity to reviewers. First, avoid using those wishy-washy phrases like, I hope to explore. Instead, use stronger, more direct ones like, this study will investigate. It's all about sounding like you've got a clear plan and know exactly what you are doing. Next, it'll be helpful to use signposting phrases to guide your readers through your ideas. Think of these as note signs that help them through your reasoning. For example, use words like building on these findings. This raises the important question of, or to tackle this limitation. These kinds of signposting phrases can make your writing flow better and show that you are thinking ahead. Lastly, notice how successful proposals keep things clear and concise. Instead of saying, many researchers have found, get specific, mention names and days like Smith 2020, Jones 2021, and Zhang 2023 have shown. It's more precise and it strengthens your argument. Okay, now we've covered the essential elements of a winning research proposal, from understanding review psychology to crafting each session for maximum impact. You are almost there. Let's wrap this up with some insight tips that give your proposal that extra edge. Remember, an excellent proposal isn't just about checking boxes. It's about telling a compelling story about why your research matters, how your research design is feasible, and why you are the right person to conduct it. Now, it's your turn. I've created a research proposal toolkit with templates, examples, and a checklist you can download from the link in the description. And if you are working on a proposal right now, share your research topic in the comments. I read every comment and love giving feedback. Your research has the potential to make a real difference in your field. A well-crafted proposal is the right step, is the first step to making that impact. Hit that like button if you found this helpful. Subscribe for more academic success videos. And remember, excellent research begins with a great proposal. See you in my next video. And hey, if you want someone to take a professional look at your proposal, make sure it's on track and that you've nailed all the important questions. Feel free to send it over to me and you can email it or submit it through my website for an edit. And the all the links are in the description below.